what is Bernoulli's theorem? The Bernoulli's theorem is explaining the sum of the total energy of the fluid which is under the motion. So let us consider a non-viscous, incompressible and irrotational fluid. This is the tube. It has two ends, one narrow end and one broad end. This tube is fixed at two different heights from the reference point. Let us say this is at a height h1, this is at a height h2. There is a height difference between h1 and h2. So when a non-viscous, incompressible and irrotational fluid flowing through a tube of flow, so its sum of potential energy, pressure energy and kinetic energy per unit volume is always remains constant at each and every point throughout the motion. This is the statement of Bernoulli's theorem. When an incompressible comma irrotational and non-viscous fluid flowing through a tube then the sum of its potential energy, comma kinetic energy and pressure energy per unit volume remains constant at each and every point through its motion. So this is called Bernoulli's theorem. So the pressure energy is P plus potential energy per unit volume is rho gh plus kinetic energy per unit volume is half rho v square is equal to constant. So this is the equation we should prove in Bernoulli's theorem. Now we will go to the proof of this Bernoulli's theorem. So let us assume a tube, it has two ends, these two ends are maintained at two different heights, not at the same heights. This is the reference point, this is and this is. The first end of the tube has area of cross section A1. Second end of the tube has area of cross section A2. The velocity of the flux entering through A1 is V1. The velocity of the flux which is leaving the area of cross section A2 is V2. This area of cross section A1, nothing but the first end of the tube is at a height H1. The second end of the tube is at a height H2. Let us consider an incompressible, irrotational and non-viscous fluid has entered to this tube. It has to cross over the different points to reach A2. Whenever this is done, what we can understand is, according to the equation of continuity, equation of continuity A1V1 is equal to A2V2. Area into velocity is constant at each and every point through its motion. So like this. Now, see the NA1. The amount of or the mass of the flux entering through A1 is like this. The mass of flux entering at A1 is equal to M1 is equal to, we can write that rho is equal to mass by volume. This refers to mass is equal to rho into volume. So, it is rho 1. V we can write as area into length. A1. Length we can write as velocity into time. Because the amount of mass M1 which is entering through the area of cross section A1 with respect to the given time dt. So that's why it is written as M1 rho 1 A1 V1 dt. So at the same time the mass of flux leaving at A2 is equal to M2. So again M2 is equal to rho 2 A2 V2 dt. The amount of work done by the fluid against its pressure at the two ends is nothing but the W1 minus W2. So the pressure difference due to the liquid motion is the work done due to the difference in pressure of the liquid is equal to work done due to the pressure is equal to rho 1 A1 V1 dt minus rho 2 A2 V2 dt. It is the work done to move the fluid from one end of the tube to the another end of the tube again as the pressure nothing but equal to the difference in the pressure. So work done due to the gravitational force at the first end. It is not only due to the potential energy or the work done due to the pressure. Whenever a flux is entering to the tube, it is overcoming the gravitational force also. That means the flux is doing some work again as the gravitational force also at the both ends. So the work done due to gravitational force at A1 is equal to MgH1, because the work done by a gravitational force is nothing but its potential energy. That's why we can write MgH1. At the same time, the work done due to gravitational force at area A2 is equal to MgH2. So the work done due to the gravitational force is given by like this. What is the change in the work? MgH1 minus MgH2. The change in work done against the gravitational force. Is equal to MgH1 minus MgH2. So according to the law of conservation of energy, work done due to the pressure plus work done due to the gravitational force is equal to the change in kinetic energy. According to the law of conservation of energy, work done due to pressure plus work done due to gravitational force, nothing but work done by a body, is equal to change in its kinetic energy. Therefore, work done due to the pressure is P1 A1 V1 dt minus P2 A2 V2 dt plus, this is work done due to the pressure. Work done due to the gravity is mg h1 minus mg h2. This is equal to change in kinetic energy means half m V2 square minus half m V1 square. Now I am dividing the whole equation with m. Therefore, P1 A1 V1 dt by m minus P2 A2 V2 dt by m plus mg h1 by m minus mg h2 by m, that is equal to half m v2 square by m minus half m v1 square by m. So now what we can understand is this m and m gets cancelled, here also m gets cancelled, m cancel, m cancel. This a1 v1 dt. So what is this a1 v1 dt? Volume. V1 into dt is length, length into area is volume. Therefore it is P1 V1 by M minus P2 V2 by M plus GH1 minus GH2 is equal to half V2 square minus half V1 square. Mass by volume is equal to density, volume by mass is equal to 1 by density. Therefore, we can write this one as P1 by rho minus P2 by rho plus GH1 minus GH2 is equal to half V2 square minus half V1 square. So if we take this one as rho as LCM, it is like this: P1 minus P2 plus rho GH1 minus rho GH2 by rho is equal to half V2 square minus half V1 square. Therefore, P1 minus P2 plus rho GH1 minus rho GH2 is equal to half rho V2 square minus half rho V1 square. Now I am bringing all 1s to one side, all 2s to another side. Therefore, the equation is P1 plus half rho V1 square plus rho GH1 is equal to P2 plus half rho V2 square plus rho GH2. So according to the equation of continuity, we can write this one as P plus half rho V square plus rho GH is equal to constant. So this is the equation we have proved. Pressure energy plus kinetic energy per unit mass plus potential energy per unit mass is equal to constant at any point of the flow of the fluid.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.